switching now.
Sure, why not?
All right, you're on, buddy.
Oh, boy.
I'm ready on time when you are.
All right, well, I hope everybody enjoyed the last run, and I hope you're all ready to get nice and comfy for story time with Uncle Dredd. Everybody, get out your comfiest blankets and your fluffiest pillows and get nice and comfy as we go through the wonderful world of Dredd versus Death. So, lit up the first time. First level. Time starts in 3, 2, 1, go.
Decade of the 22nd century. Unemployment is endemic, boredom is universal, and only the judges can prevent total anarchy. Empowered to dispense instant justice, they are judge, jury, and executioner all in one. The most feared and respected of all the judges is Dredd. He is the law.
You are adoring public. Dredd, you gotta stop holding your fan club meetings outside City Hall. Dispense with the wisecracks, Anderson. Tell Dredd what you just told me. The precogs at Side Division are predicting a terrible plague. Dredd, the last thing the city needs is an epidemic. Citizens crammed together the way they are, it would spread like wildfire.
I'll keep my ear to the ground, Chief Hershey.
In the meantime, disperse those demonstrators outside.
Consider it done.
All right, so getting started here. We need to arrest these protesting scum. They need to know the law. So we're gonna go ahead and arrest a whole bunch of them. And murder the other ones, because it's just a little bit faster. And then we're gonna immediately boost out of bounds. And this skips a pretty slow elevator. And apparently if you just like pause buffer your way down, you'll just never die to fall damage. Normally if you fall for, I think it's like 2 or 3 seconds, you just kind of instantly die. But you can just keep tabbing away and fall down nice and gently. So, also it's very easy to get stuck on pretty much every corner in this entire game. So, for this level and a bunch of others, you need to actually complete every main objective. The first of which was dealing with the protesting scum. The next is to deal with these bank robbing scum. And I will deal with them. I will dispense justice my way. Oops. I forgot the controls. It's fine, don't worry about it. We are still dispensing justice rather rapidly. Good, he ran the correct way. He did not run backwards, which is nice. So you'll notice that this category is jury. Jury means we need to watch each and every cutscene in the game to make sure we get all the evidence required to make proper judgment. So that's what we're going to be doing. So, he gotta die. We now need to take care of every single gosh darn vampire in this entire city. Hopefully it won't be too hard. Yeah, come on. Fight me. IRL. Please do. So I'm using the Lawgiver as my main weapon. There are other weapons, but they're all kind of terrible, so we're not going to be using them. And the Lawgiver has a whole bunch of different ammo types, but almost all of them are terrible. What we're going to be using is Armor Piercing, which I'm using now, and Hi-X, which we did last time. As you can see, it's pretty effective at murdering these gosh darn dropping vampires. Well, unless it just decides not to. Occasionally it just decides not to, which is rather frustrating. Maybe a couple left over here, and then we'll be done with this level. Alright. So you'll notice in the bottom right I have this little bar with an eagle on it. That's my law meter. You need to make sure that you are obeying the law as you dispense justice. So if I, say, murder too many civilians, I'll fail the mission. Alright, so this is Nixon Penitentiary. Unfortunately, those grud damn vampires, those nasty folks, they've broken on into this place, and they've, causing problems and such, because this happens to be where the Dark Judges are being kept. So, well, we gotta make sure nothing bad happens there. Most of this level is just kind of running through it, but a few fairly precise things. Switch over to armor piercing again. The next two rooms I actually have to clear out almost all the vampires before the door opens. So hopefully they decide to behave and actually stay together. One more, there he is. Oh no, I ran out of ammo. And I missed. Alright, we got there. These guys love to group together. Which they're not really doing right now. Please die. Alright, so this game has a mechanic called auto-aim. Basically, if you play the game without auto-aim, like, you know, you normally would in a PC FPS, you're basically just gonna miss most of your shots. So instead you have to have auto-aim on, and then you only miss about half your shots. It's pretty good. So here's a little skip. I didn't do the best way. You can actually get over the wall. Whoops, can't mash that button. You actually get straight over that wall so you don't have to wait for this door, but I kind of messed it up a little, but that's fine. Normally running all the way back down there is very slow, and we don't want to do that. Oh, Moogle, you silly, silly thing. You were just too busy watching Normie. Also, I'm strafe running to go faster everywhere. Shoutouts to Jashi, who literally invented strafe running, according to him. He improved so many video games, honestly. It's incredible. Also, the last few times I played this game, I played co-op, and I have to keep stopping myself from killing myself to death warp forwards, because that's a strat in co-op. It does not work in solo. I can't see, but there we go. You actually don't have to kill the ones that are on fire here. But the one on fire was blocking the one not on fire, which was rather annoying.
Dread, we've just lost contact with the chamber where the Dark Judges are being held. Get over there fast.
So the rest of this level is just a casual jaunt to the end. And after that, we get some more fantastic story. I really hope you're ready for the next cutscene. It is something. One of my favorites in the whole game. Also, when you're on fire, you can't really see anything, but it's fine. It doesn't really do much damage at all. Also, my splits have not been going. Oh well. Oh, I skipped the cutscene. I was not paying attention because I got distracted by my splits. Hold on, we can fix this after this cutscene. I will fix this, I promise you. Alright, you saw that cutscene. Don't worry, I'll fix this. Don't worry. Do this fast. This one. Whoop, that's loud. Alright, here it is. Don't worry. Don't you worry your pretty little faces, it'll be fine. There. It's probably a little bit loud.
What?
Alright. Good. I'm glad I went back to watch that cutscene. It's one of the best cutscenes. Moving on. Alright, here we have the docks. The first part of the docks, we need to deal with these criminal scum who absolutely love to hide, and they're really annoying. It's alright, we got those ones. Stuck behind this box. There we go. We got there. It's gonna get way more Ghostbusters way later. Don't even worry about it. This is actually a really large level. Oops. So that's the normal arrest animation. I've actually been canceling it by doing reloads and such. So, there, I finally got to see it. Now I'll never do it again. Alright, we've dealt with that annoying gang. Next enemies are the death cultists, and we don't actually have to worry about them at all, so we just get a nice casual saunter through the docks. while they try to murder us. But we don't worry about that. I really hope we didn't get any scumbags who are in possession of a hamster without a license. Those are the worst ones. Can't stand them. Also, I can't see Discord anymore, so I hope nothing bad happens so they have to message me. Oh well. It was worth it for the cutscene. This is such a nice, easygoing level. But of course it has an absolutely impossible skip in it. We're gonna try to go for it, but I can't guarantee it. Alright, here we go. 180 shot! Oh, I missed completely. Oh, I missed again. Oh dear. Oh, that went bad. I'm sorry. We're gonna have to wait. Oh dear. It's fine. Nothing will go wrong. I am the law after all. Alright, so here's our first epic boss fight. I hope you guys are ready for this incredibly epic boss fight. This is Necris, the leader of the Death Cult. Alright, we beat Necris, the leader of the Death Cult. I hope you enjoyed that boss fight. Now we just need to wait until the end of the level. Alright, this time I won't skip the cutscene, don't worry about it. So this is the mall. This level is basically one big circle, and you need to deal with all of the trapped civilians. Now, you may notice that I said deal with and not save. See, whenever it has an objective like arrest X people or save X people, it doesn't really mean that. It means arrest or save a minimum amount. The others just need to be, dealt with, you know? They just can't be left sitting there all alone. And, much more effective method of saving people is by blowing them up. So I'll make plenty use of that here. See if I remember how to do this boost. Go here. And then you go on up. Delicious. So these guys. Dang, they didn't make it. I really thought they were gonna make it. Oh well. Hi, Dunkmeister. How is it going? I hope you are being lawful today. These guys sometimes just don't want to die. They really sometimes just don't want to die. Alright, so there's about 10 civilians on this map. We need to save at least 3. Also, we're gonna get some head on this guy to avoid fall damage. And, conveniently, here's 3 altogether that we can save all at once. And that'll be the, total required save, guys. Also, these zombies like dancing. So we rescued the three. That's all we need. Now, unfortunately, there's four more civilians here that need saving, and I don't really have the law meter to spare to save all of, or to, I mean, protect all of them, you know? Alright, they're not dying. I think they, like, all just died right there, which is kind of convenient. Where's the, yeah, I think they all died. Oh, that was, also I forgot about this guy. That was actually really nice. They just kind of all had a poor little accident. Poor guys. It's a real shame. Alright, so this is the labs of Dr. Dick Icarus. Normally when you do this level, you can just kind of jump off to the side and pause buffer your way down to the very end of the level. But we can't do that, because that would skip a cutscene, and that would be cheating. So we're gonna play this level legit. Hello, Boix. How are you doing? This is indeed the law. Raquel, you can use, I didn't betray the law, I am the law. It's a good line. Alright, so I haven't played this level normally in a long time, so we'll see how much I actually remember. It's this way. Law. Back this way. He literally just said the plot thickens. I love that. I love that. Also, this level for some reason has the only doors in the entire game that you actually have to like press E to open. Can I get this from here? I can't remember. Like, no other doors in the entire game do you actually need to use to open. For some reason, like this one, you just gotta open it. I'm still not entirely sure why. Hey, Caramel. How are you doing?
Ah, the famous Judge Dredd. What brings you here?
Icarus, I'm shutting this facility down.
It doesn't matter. The serum is perfected. I have discovered the key to immortality. No one can stop me now.
Consider yourself stopped.
All right, we just shot Dick in the face. I hope you weren't attached to Dick. It's Dick's dead, baby. Oh, right. His body has disappeared. Oh no. Oh, I went the wrong way. Shoutouts to Walrus. The place is crumbling around us. So, if you did the skip that I talked about at the beginning, you'd actually pause buff your way down through this skylight. And you'd land down here. And it would skip everything. But unfortunately, you can't go backwards and trigger the cutscene. So it's cheating in this category. The jury has to review all the evidence. Get wrecked. Luckily there's no cutscene here, so I can just keep going. This level is basically just a straight line, but it's got some somewhat tricky maneuvering in places. Like the very start there. There we go. Alright. Gotta get up here. Now these ladies are actually pretty deadly, because they have laser pistols, which just ignore your shields. So they can take down your health pretty quick. Luckily we have Hayek on our side. Jump through some windows for style. This is Judge Goodwin. Luckily, we don't have to rescue Judge Goodwin. This would be way more annoying of a level if we did. Get wrecked, nerds. Can we get a ban on anybody who advertises for G4G? It's so incredibly annoying. I don't think they're very lawful. Alright. That guy.
Dread, Mortis is in there somewhere. We've managed to seal off the floors below.
All exits are covered.
Mortis is not leaving this building.
You got that right.
Alright, so this is hospital. This is basically split into two parts. The first one, you need to rescue a bunch of civilians trapped in here, as per the norm. So we're gonna safely save all of these poor civilians, I promise. Also, this guy's a lie.
That's a shot in the arm.
Alright, these two were saved. Now we got three more. We need serious saving. Alright, they've been saved. This level has a better route, but I just haven't bothered learning it yet. It's not that much faster. That person is humping the railing. Also, this game is, like, legitimately fun. It has problems, for sure. But I actually really enjoyed playing through it casually, and it does a lot of things that I think is pretty neat. So this judge is using incendiary. You think incendiary would be good, but it's literally the most useless ammo type. All it does is just makes the enemies bright. It eventually kills them after like 4 years. It's really dumb. Alright, now we need to wait for this elevator so we can go and murder even more things. Is she gonna win? Oh, she won. Amazing. Now we need to pacify all these vampires. before we can move on with our lives. This one is in an awful position. This one is in an even worse position. Wow. Okay, that's great. They're supposed to come running out so you can just like climb up here as they're running at you, but oh well. Alright, so now we have our second super epic boss fight. I know the first one was really disappointing, but don't worry, this one's actually going to be epic, I promise you. See, I need to like shoot these things. Can't hit this one. Alright. That was it. That was the boss fight. See, we can't just like kill him. See, if we just like killed him, then like he would just like escape in his ethereal form or something, and obviously that's no good. That's literally the entire hook for the next level. There's just fire over there. So a judge needs to deal with it, obviously.
Hey, anybody got a light?
I just realized I have another emote to make. Anyway, this is the smoketorium. We're gonna skip half the level by just boosting down here. Also, you need to shoot that robot out of the way because he will block you. Now, since we're fighting a guy made out of fire, we just need to turn on the sprinklers. And that's it. This is another super epic boss fight. You beat it by turning on sprinklers. I love this game. Legitimately. Now, somebody said something about Ghostbusters, right? Alright, so even though the last judge we couldn't kill because he'd escape as a ghost or something, this one we totally murder, and he doesn't escape as a ghost. This story is flawless. Anyway, this is Recyc. This is one of the longer levels, and we also do have some pretty big skips for it. And it's still pretty long. Get up here to get a pass to the elevator. So we'll need it. Kill those guys for sport. I don't want to destroy the world record too bad, Boix, come on.
Careful, Dredd. You're approaching the position where Dredd was last sighted.
Alright. Careful maneuvering around these guys. And now we're in decontamination. Most boring section of everything. But it's okay, because it's followed by interesting stuff. Armor piercing is pretty good against these guys. Alright, we got through there. Now there's an elevator up here on a global timer, so we'll see if we're on a good cycle. No, we're not. I think on co-op you always get here when it's down. But in solo, you're not quite fast enough. Dread has other weapons, but they're all terrible. There's no reason to ever use them. Armor piercing and high X is all you ever need in life, honestly, to be honest. Look, I just picked up a shotgun. I will never use it because it's garbage. Alright, so here's a little skip. We're just gonna boost on up here. That skips like a big chunk of the level. And then here's an actually little skip. Just going over here skips running all the way around, which is, you know, it's nice. And here's a very tiny skip. You just jump over the pipe instead of running around it. That skips like basically nothing. It's just more fun. I freaking love that cutscene, because you're just like, oh no, he's going to dump into the big vat of acid, it's going to be terrible. Oh my god, he just put his fist through his entire body. Holy crap. That is amazing. So it actually does turn out that killing them means they'll escape as a ghost. That is actually a thing. Okay, step one, turn around. Great. That's how you beat this level. No signal down here. Yeah, a little known fact. Henniko is actually the law. By the way, in case you didn't know. Yes, this level is it's another bunch of running. You turn around and then you run to the ending. But this time there is another boss fight, and I swear, I promise, this time we're actually going to have a boss fight. I know all the other boss fights were pretty silly and gimmicky. This is just a straight up for real boss fight. There's glare on my screen, and I honestly could not see that vampire. The sun is so bright that it reflects off the wall behind me and puts glare on my screen. It's rather annoying. Hello, friends. Do you have a moment to talk about our Lord and Savior, the Law? Alright, we're almost here. The end boss, well, the boss of this level is up here. This is Judge Fear. We've dealt with two of the four judges. Here's the next one. So I got my biggest weapon out. We're gonna fight this boss for real, I swear. I just need him to walk over here and then we can fight face to face IRL. He is not behaving. Come on. Go over here. He is not behaving. What the heck? Alright, down you go. Later, buddy. Good boss fight.
Control, I've trapped Judge Fear in the Egyptian vault of the Metropolitan Museum.
Roger that.
Anderson must have gone through. Drock!
Alright, last level. Alright, here we go. It's the final confrontation in Dead World.
I'm coming for you, Death.
Against the last. Oh my god, I failed that skip. I haven't failed that skip in ages. So this gate normally doesn't open unless you kill like a ton of enemies. It's obnoxiously long. But you can just like go left and then right and just easily go around it. Easy peasy. This gate actually opens a lot faster, but it's still faster just to do this.
You have already lost.
Apparently we've already lost though, huh? I guess we might as well just stop. Sorry guys. Alright, cool, we got the good weapon. Alright, so we have one more gate that we unfortunately can't skip. There's not that many enemies, so it's not that bad. Unless they want to hide. But we're... get back here. There we go. Alright, this time I promise, this last final boss, I promise it's a real end boss. Don't worry about it. Alright, so unfortunately that thing is actually indestructible, so I can't fight it. So unfortunately I just have to like, I just failed that. I don't know why I did that. We don't have to watch the cutscenes again if we've seen it. It's okay, we can skip them. So, I know you guys might hate me. But I actually, legitimately, just have to not fight it and rescue these civilians, or these judges instead.
Just one more.
It's okay. Don't worry. This is a real boss fight. Trust me. If I said how this game is actually legit fun and like a decent game, because despite how thrilling the boss fights are, it's actually really good. Alright, so now all we gotta do is wait for these good old judges to win the game for us. Now since this is jury, we can't stop time until after the final cutscene is played, so just get nice and comfy. And wait for the ending to come, baby. This guy is stuck. That's not good. Please get your ass in gear. You need to end the game for me. Please, baby. Baby, come on. Baby, don't be like this. Oh, come on. Just. Are you serious right now? Are you legitimately serious? Actually, that's never happened before. I've never seen the guy get 100% stuck on the boss like that. Oh my god. Oh, I just... No, it didn't soft lock. It's fine. You know what? We're just gonna take this calmly and casually. Take our time. We are going to finish this video game. Underestimate. They sometimes get stuck on each other, but I've never seen them just get like 100% will not move completely stuck before. Alright, we're not gonna shoot him.
Just one more.
Also, these guys, they will fuck you up. Like, gosh dang, man. They do a billion damage if they come close to you. Alright, this time. I have a good feeling about this time. They're all clear. Okay. Death. I need you to get the fuck out of the way. Are you serious? I am speechless right now. I've literally never seen a skeleton actually attack one of these people.
Just one more.
I have never in my entire life. I've done this run so times, and it has never gone this poorly. This fight has been dumb, and it's been failed before, but it's always been something stupid that I do. It's fucking never, ever been like this. Oh my god. Please, just end. We're going overestimate when we should have been like 4 minutes overestimate. Oh my god. 4 minutes under. It's okay, okay. So time doesn't end until the final cutscene plays out. Because it's jury, you need to watch all of them. I will tell you when time is.
Judge, death is trapped within me.
Oh no. Judge Death is trapped in there. What's gonna happen to her now? Will she be okay?
We just eliminated the last of the vampires from Sector 5. The regen infestation is over.
Good work, Dredd. Rest assured that we're stepping up security on the Dark Judges.
What about Anderson?
Containing Judge Death's essence was a terrible strain on her.
But she's doing fine, thank you very much.
Oh, she's just fine.
Joe, you weren't worried about me, were you?
Alright then.
Control to Dredd. Block 4 in progress. Corner of Reeves and Hopper.
On my way, Control. Dredd out.
I guess we'll never know.
Okay, get ready on time. Time, baby. You're not wrong, Remy. You're not wrong.
All right. It's a 51:29. I'm gonna have to take your speedrunning license.
I am the law.
Revoked.
You can't tell me what the estimate is. I am the law.
Just like the movie. Law. Give me your badge.
I didn't betray the estimate. I am the estimate.
Well, this is a good run. This is a pretty hot game. And you saved the marathon.
Well, the next game, there's no possible way for the next game to go poorly, so this is going to go excellently.
Oh yeah, of course, nothing bad ever happens in Dishonored, which is coming up next.
Nothing bad
ever happens. Yeah, we'll be right back.